read this prayer together, because sometimes other people's language can put to words things we can't put to words. And this is called A Litany for Those Not Ready for Healing by Dr. Yolanda Pierce. And so just hold this as maybe she is able to put to words things that your own soul hasn't been able to speak yet. Let us not rush to the language of healing before understanding the fullness of the injury and the depth of the wound. Let us not rush to offer a Band-Aid when the gaping wound requires surgery and complete reconstruction. Let us not offer false equivalencies, thereby diminishing the particular pain being felt in a particular circumstance, in a particular historical moment. Let us not speak of reconciliation without speaking of reparations and restoration, or how we can repair the breach and how we can restore the loss. Let us not rush past the loss of this mother's child, this father's child, someone's beloved son. Let us not value property over people. Let us not protect material objects while human lives hang in the balance. Let us not value a false peace over a righteous justice. Let us not be afraid to sit with the ugliness, the messiness, and the pain that is life in community together. Let us not offer cliches to the grieving, those whose hearts are being torn asunder.
Instead, let us mourn Black and brown men and women, those killed extrajudicially every 28 hours. Let us lament the loss of a teenager dead at the hands of a police officer who described him as a demon. Let us weep at a criminal justice system which is neither blind nor just. Let us call for the mourning men and the wailing women, those who are willing to rend their garments of privilege and ease and sit in the ashes of this nation's original sin. Let us be silent when we don't know what to say. Let us be humble and listen to the pain, rage, and grief pouring from the lips of our neighbors and friends. Let us decrease so that our brothers and sisters who live on the other's underside of history may increase. Let us pray with our eyes open and our feet firmly planted on the ground. Let us listen to shattering glass, and let us smell the purifying fires, for it is the language of the unheard. God, in your mercy, show me my own complicity in justice. Convict me for my indifference. Forgive me when I remain silent. Equip me with a zeal for righteousness. Let me never grow accustomed or acclimated to unrighteousness.